Okay, let's do some notifications. And let's start some coding. Okay, the message is almost ready. Send now. Let's see. Good. This one is done. Let's see. Oh. Which has a wrong profile of me. Still an old profile picture. Let me change that. Okay, I'll do it later. So, let's wait a little bit. Maybe some more people will come over. Oh, what's up with my what's up with my bitrate? Okay, the bitrate has stabilized. Looks good. Let's go. Let's start working on something. Let's switch to a nice cam. So today I'm wearing a special Mage-OS hat in order to commemorate my work on Mage-OS database changelog. So, if you are new to this stream series, the database changelog is some kind of tool that helps you to monitor what has changed in MySQL database by listening as replication client, and then you can see all the data that was submitted to MySQL in aggregated way. So, my task right now, like I was working with some low-level library, I managed to improve a little bit the part that I was struggling last time with off-stream. I did create a couple of abstractions, as you can see, like there's a bunch of stuff has been done already in a functionality. So now I'm just gonna go and finalize some of the stuff. So right now, I think last time I was I stopped with nullable bit vectors for columns that are received from binary log event. So let's go and hey, Faran, nice to meet you again. So let's do some stuff. So what did I stop here first? So first I created this test. Let's actually run the tests. Let's see. Okay, the tests are passing, but this one mark columns is null when all columns in image present. So here we have a table itself. We are gonna take as an entity table, right? Probably I need to enlarge a little bit the viewport. Let's see. Oh, it's already quite good, I think. Let me know if you want to have it larger. Yeah, I recognize you, Francis. How are the things going for you? Do you have anything to rant about? Okay, so we have some stuff here. So what I'm trying to do now, like there is this binary mask that gets sent from MySQL server for each of the rows in binary log, which indicates which of the values of columns are actually null values. So it's gonna set and one bit per each of the column in position. So what I'm doing, like I created an abstraction that basically gonna take all of the columns that are supplied in a binary row and gonna mark them, are they nullable or not. So later on when we're gonna parse rows, it's gonna be easier for us to access which, if this column is actually a null value. Because by default, like in MySQL, you would have to iterate over all of the bits and then you have to adjust based on which column is set or not set. And I wanna make this code simpler, so I'm structuring it away. I already did it for partial columns. So the partial columns are JSON fields. I already have it covered by tests and working. Now I'm working on the null columns bits. So the first test case is passing, but second one, I think I didn't finish yet a test case, right? So here we have like first two columns. Those are not null. And if we take a look at the entity table, let me open it up. The entity table has the first two columns are entity ID and name, and then description and price. So basically what it means that my test case tells that price and description are going to be null. So let's go and implement it. So null column bits, bit slice. Yeah, so the bit slice will tell that all of the columns are present. So where it is, this one I don't need. This one too. Okay, so the fixture. 1, 2, 3, 4. So four columns. So we need to create bit slice. U8. From slice, and as a slice we're gonna supply just some binary, so minus b, and it's gonna be four columns present, so it's gonna be something like that. So the first four columns are present in a row, The rest are still need to be specified because it's 1 byte. So we have to specify it. That one is going to be passed, right? But it accepts actually a reference. So we need to make sure that it's a reference. And then we supply buffer. So buffer will tell that only these two columns are nulls. So I expect that my test case should look something like this. First thing is going to be null bits is set 0 and then is set 1. So the second column, the third column, and the fourth column. Then we're gonna specify vector to which we compare the values, and the first one is gonna be false because it's not a null value, because based on this bit mask it's specified. Then we have another one as true, and the last one as true. So let's run a test to verify that it fails. Yeah, it fails. It's good. Because for now I just made the previous thing passing. So what we need to do now, we need to take all of the current columns we have. And we need to map them. Right? Or we don't need to map them. Probably we just need to have a length, right? We don't care about anything else. We just care about the length of this vector. So we know how much bits we have in our offset column. So total columns equals this. Then what we need to do, we need to walk through our offset columns. And let's say we have a mutable bitvec of null columns. Capacity is going to be total columns. So we want to make sure that it's allocated, so we are not allocating on every single push. Then we're going to do 4 of row set columns. So we're gonna have is column set in, and if is column set as actually probably deref, right? So let's see what kind of value it's dereferences to. Probably to something like that. So we probably can do something like this. Let's run a test just to verify. Okay, so it tells me that something is not specified. Oh yeah. I didn't specify what is the type of the bitvec. Good. Now it passes and it compiles. It's good. So we check, okay, if the column is set in this row, then we can even one line it, right? Because we have to fill in every single column. So we're gonna push a value of true or false, and it's basically gonna be if column is set and we forgot small thing. One of the best things in MySQL that exists, it's called receiving that, how do I call it? Receiving that bit values, right, from a buffer. So I have already some code here, like we have basically to parse it like that. We'll call it nullable bits, but we're gonna say it's offset columns. Count once, right? Or it's something different. Let me actually check in a row what is done in the original module. So how does the nullable check happens? So it takes this index for that one, but for null, okay, it takes image index. So it still expects it to be as part of offset columns. So it's probably also use counts once, right? Let's look into it. Null bitmap, num bits. Yeah, so calls count once. Okay, so that's correct. That one should be parsed, and then we set bit slice. Okay, and we're gonna have bit slice U8 from slice of nullable bits. And then we can use that one here. Get. We can actually convert it into iter. So it's gonna be iterator. And then we can do a small trick here. We can take probably next, sorry, not take, next. Then we're gonna say unwrap or we probably have to map here, right? And we're gonna map a value into something like that. The next and wrap or false. But we need to make it mutable. So what do we have here? Self offset columns. Let's see. Nullable bits next. Oh yeah, I forgot this one. It should be basically just offset columns. not self for set columns, right? Okay, the test fails because it returns false, 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 but should return false, false, true, true. Let's take a look what's going on. Oh yeah, because I don't return back this thing, right? Okay, that's good. At least some progress. But why it happens? I know what's going on. Yeah, my bad. I just did wrong data. Because... Or no, basically I did stuff correctly, right? So it takes a look if the bit is set. It should be something like that. Okay, I need to do a quick answer in the chat. What do we have here? We have false, false, true, and then false. So it should return false for this too. Then it should return one. Did I mess up with the bit count? No, the bit count is good. Total four columns. The row set column is clear. Buffer parse, row set column count once. So what's actually is the result here? Let's put a breakpoint, let's debug. So it means it should work. Okay, total columns is 4, as expected. Oh, there is a panic, okay. Oh, yeah, because it's a test. Okay, let's see here. Let's restart debug. Probably I have to restart just the failing test. Let's debug just a failing test. Now we're definitely gonna receive the right data. Okay, so total columns is 4. Then that value is gonna be set. Now total columns is 11. Okay, that's clear. Because 7 plus 4. Small bits should be What's actually the number of bits? Maybe I messed up something here. As it usually can happen. Okay, so full commas is okay. Total bits is 1, so it's not total bits, of course, it's total bytes, but okay. We parse 1 byte. It's a slice. But then we walk through a bunch of stuff here. So we received that nullable bit slice. Could be possible that this one gets still evaluated. Okay, so let's separate it. Let value equal to match of is column set def and we're gonna say that if it's sum true, or we can just do something. Sorry, not sum, it's just true, right? If it's true, then we take that bit, because I think it could be possible that the optimizer decides to execute both of the statements. Okay, but false is gonna be false. And then we just push this value, because I think we are extracting a couple of values at the same time. Or yeah, it should not be the case, ideally, but yeah, it could still happen. Okay, now at least I can see what's going on here. So this part we know is working. So nullable bits slice. Okay. See what's in there. Yeah, it's a pointer to a memory. Let's align that thing. Oh, we don't need it anymore separate. Okay, what I did here, I basically just cloned that value. Let's just do that, maybe. Because it looks like the regular thing doesn't work. What was it? Nullable. No columns, right? Null columns. What we have here? We have row set columns. Does it take just a reference to self? Okay, that should work. So let's just do the same thing. Something that definitely works. The only thing that we have to do it the other way around, right? Let's put it here in columns. Then match mutable position. Hey, did the stream restart or something? Looks like not. Okay. Then we have some null columns, get mute index. Okay, then we do we shouldn't have an issue with it, right? It should not be possible to not get immutable because it must be set. So basically we can have just an unwrap here. Then we're gonna take this value. And we're gonna set this value here. So then it should be correctly set, ideally. But still, it's false, false, true, false. Let's see. Is null false, that's correct. Is null false, that's also correct. This one should be true. And that's correct. And that's correct. Oh, so everything is fine. Everything is working correct. It would be fun to find out that I actually made a mistake in a test. Let's see. Is it the case? No? Oh yeah, I did. Look. I missed one single index, and because of that, it is not as I expected. That's fun. Okay. It works. Now we can proceed here and basically do all the stuff we need. So let's build now a test case. So we have some rows data that is a write entity event. We know what should be returned, right? This items. That's already fine. What do we do here? Oh yeah, so we have some binary rows table, so we basically change our definition here to binary table, right, because we don't care anymore about the table map event because we already adapted it to make something better from it. Now, when we have that, we can work here with some better stuff, right? So here we can also replace the table map event with the binary table. And probably we can work with just a reference to it, so we don't want to copy it over. Just do some flexes, but change this one to a reference. Because we don't want to allocate additional, we don't want to do any copies. So the binary table is there. Okay, good. So we don't need to count this stuff. What it complains about? Okay. Yeah, because the test case doesn't do anything good. Okay, now we can run this test. and it's going to be an infinite loop because I don't actually parse anything. So there's a lot of boilerplate going on, but that's fine. Convert single write event for entity, that's good. All is fine there. So in the end, I only need binary bin log value because I'm not using anything else. I also don't use those functions anymore. This one I just used to make the test easier. Again, infinite loop. Okay, so here we go, parses bunch of stuff. We here do this thing. So we initialize it with none. But what's going on in the original one? Original row just takes first partial columns. Okay, it's not important for us. This one knows how much total values are. Okay. Where is the code? Here. So num columns. And num columns is arriving from here. Do we need that here? Actually, no. For a very simple reason, because we instantiate all of them, so we can limit. This is actually the total number of columns. Table, okay, so it will make it even simpler. Then what we can say is that here we probably can tell from a table info itself that information we can arrive to it, right? So we can go here and modify our binary table to just have this getter method. Num columns self. Let's make it u size. And we just gonna return back self column types length. That should work. Good. Okay. And I don't need to do something like this. I just need to do a small vec with capacity of table info length. Yeah, we need to change a little bit stuff here. So, num columns. Right, so it's going to be our capacity as an option. Okay. What I'm doing now is also check nullable columns. we're gonna read this null columns bits. We're gonna pass around the columns itself, and we're gonna pass around the buffer. And the buffer actually needs to be mutable. Oh, we already have it as mutable reference. Okay, so we passed it over there. After we've done with it, we can do isSet check. Okay, good. Now what we do for with index in 0 till the end. So it's gonna be table info columns. And what we can do here, we can mark it as inline, because we already call it at least twice in our code over there, so we don't introduce redundant ref calls. Okay, now what we do here, we have an index in nullable columns, and we check we're gonna check columns get index, and we're gonna match it. So if we have the column, and if it's sum, true, then we do that thing with adding something. Otherwise, we're gonna do none. And what it's gonna do, it's gonna do values push this thing, right? And here it's gonna be sum, and the sum is gonna be parsing of that value, right? Where is our row? Okay, here. We're gonna make it a little bit arranged like this, and the column type is gonna be a table info get column type, table info happens if there is no metadata. Let's see what's kind of a type. Okay, column type. So ideally it should never be the case. Okay, let's see. probably can move it here. And is it like, you know what? I probably should just transform it from option into error so I can just propagate it up if it's missing. Right. So I need to change a little bit my tests here. Because I expect that the value is there. Actually, something like that. And we're gonna switch it up. Also gonna unwrap. Gonna for now comment this piece of code. Okay, good. Let's go back to binary table. Let's run tests here. So this still works all right. Now we need to unwrap. Is still passing. Okay. Good. Now we can change the step. I can just do something like this. I can just specify here IO result. Instead of option, and here I'm gonna say ok, and here I would say unimplemented, so we'll implement it later, so it'll panic if something hits. So it should be something like that. Okay, it builds. It's good. It builds. Okay, let's change a little bit the music. It annoys me. Let's do something more upbeat, maybe. Let's see what epidemic sounds offers us. Let's do some electronic, maybe. No, not really. Okay, let's do focus and study. Let's see if it's better. So.
Okay. And then here, we need to add another test case. And we say it errors out when column type is not available. So we need to do std io s std io result error, right? Or maybe we should do something different. Okay, let's look. Let's copy this part over and we are gonna access table get column type, something like 100, right? So there is definitely no 100 column. So we're gonna unwrap error and we're gonna assert that it equals to something. I don't know yet what I'm gonna assign to it. Let's do IO error. Does it implement anything? Okay, that error doesn't derive, probably doesn't derive anything interesting. Okay, we have to play around with it. I just do something like that. Error kind, what is it? Invalid data? Right, let's just compare something like that. Okay, it's not implemented. Okay, it passes a test. But what if I wanna do something like okay, I need to import it. I want to also add some text.
and you're gonna create a custom one, right? Okay, so I can use strings. Okay, that's good. Gonna be error kind invalid data, and we're gonna pass around a formatted message. That is not available in table map event. Okay, that should be good. Let's go and do the second one with the column metadata. We're just gonna copy paste some tests, and we're gonna modify it. It errors out when column metadata is not available. Okay, good. Column, get column metadata. Do we have anything else here? Okay. Nothing interesting, really. Let's go. Let's do it. Let's just use invalid data. Okay, get column metadata. Let's see it fail. Yeah, it fails. You know, like, I don't like it in front of a method, in front of a test name. I just copy that over, but this time column does not have metadata in table map event, something that we are expecting. Okay, that one is done. What next we have? I think that's all. We can switch back to the row parsing. So we wanted to access this one and this one. Okay, let's go back to our rows. So gonna get here column type, which is gonna be table info get column type of that index, and we're gonna gracefully return an error. Then we're gonna have column metadata to be equal table info get column metadata for this index, right? And then two boolean values. We're gonna hard code those values for now.
So we're gonna say, okay, here we're gonna have some data being passed around. So we're gonna parse. So we're gonna return something. And what it's gonna be? It's gonna be our buffer parse of that specific binary value, right? And the context is gonna be column type, then column metadata, then false. Not everything is false, right? Something that we need to access, okay, is unsigned. So is partial is gonna be false, but is unsigned is gonna be checked from table info is unsigned or index. And here for now, for partial data, we're just gonna return false. So it should be it. Okay. Found. Okay, so the get is an option. Graceful error. Okay. Lifetime defined here. Oh yeah, because we need to transform to owned. And now we also have to annotate it with bin log value. What else it complains about? Okay, how it's done over there. Into owned, not to owned. Okay, that's a problem. Now it compiles. Okay, can we just run a test? Okay, it still runs infinitely long. So table info is passed around. The buffer is still full.
so it's not really that good here. So columns, table is passed around. But it's still doing something with the values that it's not actually taking them into account. Yeah, let's look through this port. Capacity is zero. What? That's weird. The value is not yet there. Okay, let's restart the debugger from this point. So we have a column type. SQL type long, okay, so it's probably an ID, right? Do we reach this piece of code? Probably we don't, and that's why it fails. No, it reaches it. Okay, so what does it have here? Values. Okay, so the value is there. And the third value is there. What do I have in a test case? Four values, okay. So it should be the fourth value too. Okay, for now it's only two. So the fourth value is not... Interesting. Oh no, here is the first value, the fourth value, okay. It doesn't let me inspect. But what is the state right now of the buffer itself? The buffer should be smaller now. But it's not. Right, because as soon as I do parse, should the parse unchecked. It should basically move it, right? Checked it off the buffer for that length or unexpected end. Okay. Probably know what is the problem. I think here we reach the end. Where is the end of the buffer? Okay. We need to do if self data is empty, return none. So we need to break this loop. Okay, now we are talking. Let's see the difference. So yeah, the actual value is different, but that's fine. It's interesting that decimal is not stored as double, but yeah, it's understandable. Okay, good. The test passed, and I'm super happy. Okay. it works. So we achieved the thing. We did it. We did it. And we finally have something working. So far, I think it's a good progress. And we can finish the stream on a good note. So what's left is basically just convert other events and we are done, and then we can go into other parts of the system. So see you on the next stream, but this week we're gonna have a different one. On Friday I'm gonna have a deep dive into Axum backend framework for Rust, and we're gonna write a full page cache basically for it. So we're gonna emulate caching, because I use Axum for Laptos, and when Laptos does server-side rendering, I want to make sure that it doesn't render twice the same thing, right? So I want to make sure that based on received URL, it will output the same data. So we're gonna start working on something a little bit less involved than database. So see you this Friday. I hope you enjoyed the stream, and thank you very much for watching.